understand who you are. I don't understand the program. I don't understand all this stuff, okay? I realize now that I barely knew you before. I don't want to end up like Jason, okay? I don't want to be pushed away. I don't want it to happen twice. Let's do it, and let's fucking do it full on, or let's not do it at all. Fuck. See? Fuck. Fuck! Fuck!
A lot of the younger bands don't really have anything too original or new to offer. They just do and repeat things that have really already been done, you know, 5 years ago by other bands. And that's where I think we're a little different, because we try and put as much originality and sort of just different things into what we do than most other new bands. Most new bands try to just follow really what's already been done. And we try and just put our own new thing into it as much as we can.
This is how you take a normal, good-sounding snare drum and turn it into the complete abortion of Saint Anger. Okay, you ready? Rock and roll? Saint Anger. Happy? Bad? Anger.
Aldous!
Hello, interesting, man.
Babe, we should really get back to Naples. He's waiting back there for us.
So why don't you go and sue Napster, you little Danish twat?
Hello? Hey, frat boy.
What the hell do you think you're doing, man?
We're not stealing, okay? We're just sharing with each other, you know?
So it's like if I take this soda can right here, take a sip out of it.
Oh my God! I'm sharing my soda with Lars Ulrich! Ah! Oh my
God. And you know what? I'm just sharing 10 years of groupies with you, frat boy.
Napster. Sharing's only fun when it's not your stuff.
Sounds like you're adding one more in there on it.
Sounds like you're going.
Listen, 5 years ago you were No, come on.
You're my friend.
Put this thing together.
Friend. You're my friend, but I'm telling you.
Whoa, man.
No, you're just doing the Stone Cold crazy, bro.
Come in here and get all uppity and shit. You always start the bass accents early. Every time this summer.
It's just a brain fart.
It's okay.
I've done it twice.
Oh, fuck
twice.
With me,
come on, dude.
I'm watching you. Okay?
In fact, the last time
I'm fucking
didn't do
watching
it.
You, okay? Don't fucking start
I know
with
my
me.
Mistakes.
Are you done correcting
while,
me?
No. We just haven't played in a while, bro.
Put that thing together when you were like in Mexico.
I know, we're still, you know, trying to get in and shit.
Hey,
why not?
Hey, how are you doing?
How
are
you?
I'm brilliant.
Huh?
Yeah, I'm brilliant.
I was wondering, I've got the other guys to sign my leg, which is
of course.
Oh, yeah, the silver one's pretty good.
Alright.
I'm gonna come out here.
Thank you.
You know, do you want to have a good, give you a good seat up on stage?
Yeah.
Right in the middle of the action?
Yeah.
If you want, you can come back up. If you want, you can come back and talk to you. Where's Mom? She's back there.
Bring for Jack.
Ain't that?
I'm trying to get him.
So if you want to come and hang out back behind the drum kit for a while.
Wow.
Cool?
Yeah.
All right.
With almost no exceptions, every hard rock band in the last 40 years, including mine, traces its lineage back directly to Black Sabbath, Led Zeppelin, and Deep Purple. I'm concerned these three bands should always be considered equals for their songwriting, their recordings, and their accomplishments. Where I grew up, and in the rest of the world outside of North America, all were equal in stature and influence. So in my heart, and I know I speak for many of my fellow musicians and billions of Purple fans, when I confess that I am somewhat bewildered that they are so late in getting in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.